Good evening, and welcome to the concert tonight. We're excited to feature the Percussion Ensemble and the LaGrange College Singers. And we're also excited to share with you just a little bit of some of the inside stories of our students, the things, milestone moments in their lives, things that impacted them along their musical journeys. And that's why we've titled this concert, The Journey.
And we, as brother and sister, have had our own musical journey, which has mostly been shared with each other for over the past 20 years?
30 years?
40 years? A long time.
A long time. And we're also sharing the stage with some friends.
Yes, we have some great musical friends that live in this area, and they perform with us on a regular basis. And so we're excited to have them join us this evening.
Mm-hmm. We're also excited to share the stage with some great student musicians. And we know they're going to make their mark on the world. We're excited about where their musical journeys are taking them.
So everybody, we hope you enjoy the concert this evening.
Yeah. Thanks for coming.
Worship has always been like a big part of my life, and so being able to express that and to share that with other people, it's obviously a very spiritual thing for me. And at some point, I took a piano lesson with one of the pianists at our church, and I wasn't feeling it, so I went back home and thought it was going to be my thing. And then from there, I just found myself messing around on my keyboard at home and figured out a song, and I didn't know what it was until I realized it was Pachelbel's Canon. And once I learned that song, I decided to take those chords and kind of mess them around, mix them up, and write my own song with it, and added my own melody, my own lyrics, and that was my first song I'd ever written, and I haven't stopped since, so.
I'm here at LaGrange as a film major. I'm not a music major, I'm not a music minor, but I just love music so much, so I decided that I was gonna join the percussion ensemble, do the marching band, all stuff like that. it was really beneficial to have just like an upbringing in different instruments and vocal performance and stuff, because right now I feel really comfortable in many different areas. And like Ken's great, he teaches so much. He keeps giving me these marimba etudes that I don't think I ever would have played if he wasn't just like, no, you're gonna play this like next week, learn it. And then I do, and it's so much more, because you know, high school band, they don't really give you, percussionist at least, you don't get etudes. You get concert band pieces where you play for like four measures and then you're done, you know. So here it was really nice to be able to play in front of other people long, you know, 4 or 5 page pieces.
Thank you. I'm a junior composition and music technology major, and my goal after graduating is to get a job with a recording studio and make music. So when I was a kid, I was about 5 or 6. I lived in a little trailer park, and my parents didn't have a whole lot. But there was this church across the street, and I've always loved music, but hadn't really thought of it much up until that point. So I was outside playing in the yard on a Sunday morning, and across the street, I could hear music coming from the church, and I got really curious. So I left the house, I walked over to the church, and I went inside. And I walked straight up to the stage, got on stage with the people playing music, and they just let me dance up there. I went back home after that, and I got in a lot of trouble, but it was worth it. And I've loved being on stage and doing music ever since.
I remember very distinctly, I was 13 years old. We were at one of our choir concerts, and the men performed a song called Say Something by A Great Big World. And that's the first time I remember music really speaking to me. And I remember thinking to myself, I was like, I'd be an idiot to give this up. You know, this is what I want to do. I want to be able to tell people these stories with this music. And that's kind of where I decided, I don't care what anyone says. This is where I'm supposed to be at, you know?
When I first came to LaGrange College, I had thought that I'd be spending my years as an English major here. I had never written a serious music composition in my life, and generally believed that writing music was reserved to an elite superhuman few. However, I had worked at a movie theater, and I spent my days there sweeping up popcorn to all of the best Hollywood soundtracks played on a glorious theater surround sound system. And it was realizing how much I enjoyed these popcorn sweeping moments that prompted me my second week here at LaGrange College to ask about either becoming a film major or a music composition major. And to my surprise, Dr. Turner told me that I could complete both degrees and still graduate on time. So now heading into my final spring semester, getting ready to shoot a full film and score it also, looking back, I know that I would never have made it to this point without the guidance and support of all of the LaGrange College music and film faculty.
Thank you. I have been very fortunate that I have got to serve as a teacher missionary in Tahoe City, California for the last two summers. And this past summer, I taught 4 and 5 year olds, and I had a very new 4 year old come into my class. And it was very apparent that she had not been in school yet, and that she came from a primarily Spanish-speaking home, which meant that she had not had much exposure to English yet. Nap time was not a normal part of our routine every day, but it was for her. And wherever we were, if we were on the recess field, she would crawl up in my lap and she would fall asleep. And one day she asked me to sing her a lullaby. And I was, you know, sitting there, I was like thinking of a bunch of, you know, all these English lullabies. And then I remembered that a couple years ago in a choir, Dr. Miller had taught us a Spanish lullaby. And it was a lullaby that we performed in our lessons in carols. And so I began to sing that lullaby to her in Spanish. And the look that she had on her face from the moment that I was singing Spanish to her was unforgettable.
Back in Jacksonville, it was a month or two before I was heading off to college. I had accepted to go here at LaGrange, and someone named Linda Davis, who was a Grammy Award-winning country artist, was holding a performance class in Jacksonville. And after I had finished performing, she told me that I had a naturally great voice, and the fact that I had not received any vocal training up until that point was very surprising to her. Keep performing and you'll go really far. That kind of was that driving nail in the coffin, like, this is the right decision for me to make. I know that I'm making the right decision in my life to pursue this as a career.
And of course I came to LaGrange and I auditioned. And when I originally came, I just auditioned to be a theater arts major because all I wanted to do was act. I knew I couldn't sing. And Dr. Anderson was in the room with us, and she made me sing. She got at the piano, and she said, I don't care if it's even Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. I just want to hear you sing. So I sang something that I can't even remember what I sang, but I opened my mouth, and I maybe sang 4 notes. And then she looked at Professor Noel in the face, and she went, I want him. And so I think that was the first moment that I really understood that I could do musical theater, and I've worked really hard over the past 4 years because I was not musically inclined at birth. So I've worked really hard, and thanks to her, I'm very confident that I can go on and do musical theater for the rest of my life.
My story begins from a very early age. My mom and dad have both been in music for pretty much their whole lives. My mom is a singer. My dad is a sound engineer. So my mom has always told me stories of when I was a baby. I'd be sitting in the back seat of the car, in my car seat, and they'd turn on Metallica, any Metallica song, but specifically Enter Sandman, and next thing they know, I would be knocked out in the back seat. And they're like, it's gotta be the bass, something that we've never really figured out why it put me to sleep, but it would. But my senior year of high school, the marching band director decided that he was gonna have a rock band on the field. He was also the guitar teacher, and he's known my mom since they were in high school. So I was like, hey, can I be in the rock band? He's like, sure. And they had guitar, bass, synthesizer, drums. And I was like, synthesizer? I can play that. So I played synthesizer, ran sound. And that was the most fun I've ever had in my life. It's like the first marching experience I had, the first, I'd never been to a football game until then, and I realized I loved the adrenaline on Friday nights. I loved practicing for it. I liked the marching and all, like the structure of it. And that was when I realized that I wanted to teach. I've always wanted to do something with music, but I knew I want to be a band director. I want to teach music because I saw what an impact it had on my life. I've tried doing like elementary music, choir. I've gotten those experiences from field experience and stuff, but in my band experiences, the best experiences I've had, it's like, okay, I know this is what I want to be doing for the rest of my life. So that's my plan.
So my dad is deaf, so he doesn't hear, but on my mom's side of the family, they're all musicians, and they sing, they play instruments. A lot of them don't pursue music, but a lot of them do music. We don't have instruments in our church, so it's a cappella, which is kind of where I learned how to stay on pitch and just listen to the people around me. So my senior year, I went to this music educators convention, and at that convention, I took one of their sight singing classes, and hearing them sight sing was an incredible experience. It's practice-based, so you have to practice sight singing, and you have to know where your pitches are. So a whole group, a whole people that never met each other, just coming together to sight sing one piece. I am studying music education, so I'm not sure if I want to do band or choir yet, but I do know I want to be around middle schoolers and teaching them.
Thank you. The pandemic had started when I had been halfway through my senior year of high school. And then I came to college as we were working through that sort of second big part of the pandemic. And here in the music department, we got to do Lessons in Carols last year, which was a big filmed event. And everybody's efforts were kind of combined together just to make sure that we could get on stage and sing and provide a bit of levity for people going through some of the toughest times in their lives. And then we got to do shows last year and this last semester as well, which was really, really fun to actually get to do a show without a mask on. But I don't know, it feels like we're starting to come back to a place where we can actually perform again and feel like we're creating something that's just as valuable as before the pandemic.
Thank you.
We want to pause for just a minute and say a really big thank you to two very special people who've been such big supporters of the music program and who've made an incredible difference in the life of the percussion ensemble, Austin and Dan Cook.
So over 10 years ago, when we began the ensemble, we were very limited in our instrumentation, and so the Cook brothers came up and said, "What can we help you with? Because we see that this is something that is very enjoyable to the community, and we would like it to continue." So through their generous offerings and gifts, we were able to purchase the instruments that we needed to make the ensemble grow and continue.
This past year has been a difficult one for Austin and Dan Cook, especially for Austin, and we know that. And so tonight, we not only want to say thank you, but we want to dedicate this next song to you and say your amazing positive attitude and the way you've handled all of the hurdles that life has thrown your way, and the way you always say to me when I call, "What's going on with the music program? What's going on with those students?" means everything in the world to us. So please enjoy this next song dedicated to you.
Thank you. Separation, 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 separation